My name is Shruthi Muralidharan. I am a senior in biomedical engineering, and I'll be graduating this May. So I applied to an Engineering World Health Summer Institute program. I heard about it around last fall, and then our chapter here was really pushing for students to apply. I applied, and then our chapter raised a lot of donations and funds to send three of our students abroad this summer. My travel, I got to go to Nicaragua, which was amazing. So, and Engineering World Health is an organization, it's a nonprofit organization based out of Duke University, out of Dr. Robert Malkin's lab. He kind of started the program because he wanted to help with healthcare in world developing countries. But the students that applied were from both nationally and international. So it was an amazing program, not only to work in a developing world country, but to meet students from all over the place. The first month in the program, we were stationed in a home stay with a home stay family. And we went to school. We had 4 hours of Spanish in the morning, lunch and engineering lecture, and then engineering lab for after that. And then afterwards, we would just be with the family, do whatever they do, eat dinner, play games, practice my Spanish, because I went in not knowing anything at all. And then the second month, we were traveled to a different city within Nicaragua. We were partnered off with one other student, and we were with another homestay family, but this time it was more of a working situation, so we'd wake up and go to the hospital from like 9 to 3 every day, and just work with technicians and doctors and repair whatever equipment they gave us. So I've always been interested in studying abroad. I love traveling, and I figured that while I'm abroad, I might as well do something passionate that I'm passionate about. But with engineering, it's kind of hard to find a study abroad that's more appropriate. So when I came across this, it was more of a healthcare, engineering, biomedical, all wrapped up into one. So I was very interested in applying, and I did. Through the application process, there was a phone call interview, and that's done by a previous alumni of the Institute. And they asked for questions and things and try to make sure that you're very adaptable to the environment. And I elaborated on the fact that I have a lot of international travel. So I guess those are some key factors. Even if you've never gone outside of the country, I think if you have an open mind to things, it's really that's what they're really looking for. Last year, I was working with Anita Taylor under the Engineering Career Services. So I was able to sneak in and go bother Laura Lemza whenever and let her review my essays and for the application process. And both of them actually contributed to the donations of the travel. So if you're interested, I would definitely say apply. If you like helping people, if you like math and science, that it's something that you're never going to regret doing. You'll come back with more experiences than you've ever imagined. And if you're interested, please let me know. I run the organization with the rest of the board members, so I'd be happy to help you through the process. The second month when we were in the hospital going day to day, what I picked up and learned was that you have to be very resourceful and innovative with the given environment. You don't necessarily have materials and high-end things that you could just go to and access very easily. So I learned a lot from the technicians of how to just repair things from the things that you can find around your in the work shed, essentially. So as an engineer, I think understanding your audience is very important, especially in the design and innovation side, which is what I'm interested in. So this experience allowed me to go into an environment that they didn't really have many things and just be able to innovate and create things that were just based on of what they could use in that environment and understand that kind of target market. I am graduating in May, so I'm hopefully trying to line up a job and or grad school afterwards. I'd say I would make it real by, I had a goal in mind and I kind of just set my goal and didn't look back, and with the help of others within the School of Engineering, I was able to make that possible.